All right, here we go. Winner right off the bat.
Two times odds. Feel bet for Katie.
Thank you.
We got a lot of money out there now. Here we go.
Goodbye, $100. I don't care.
Five.
Please place your bet.
All right. So clearly the field bets are losing for us right now. So we're
Which
not going to do those right now.
Normally the five, the yeah. field does great for me, but
it's lost.
Today.
It's lost a lot. Three.
The field would have won.
It knows.
It knows. I always keep it on the field, even if it's losing, because it comes back. But that's just me.
Four.
Field would have won again.
I'm not going there. It's not going to do that to me.
Yeah, that's
not,
true. It
I don't,
would for me.
I don't play emotionally.
I do. Field bet anybody?
Nine, winner.
Yay.
There we go.
Look at some of our money back.
$35 because I put odds on it.
We should walk away and then try another machine. But I think we should first get some breakfast, honestly.
That's a good idea.
Why don't we do that? Because we
I am hungry.
Because we got kind of like back up to where we were.
Yeah.
I feel like let's just be smart. This was a fun little dive in.
Well, we just wanted to kind of, you know, get our feet wet, as you said, kind of dive in.
Dip your toes
in. Dip our toes in. It's almost like, you know, when you can play Keno at the diner usually back in the day.
Yes.
You can't really do that anymore. So we had to get in a little gambling before we have breakfast. So
this is our breakfast roll. So I think you cash that sucker.
And I need
out.
Coffee. All right, let's
cash
it out.
Yes. So really, what did we lose?
$675.
There you go. But we had a good time, didn't we?
We had a good time. Had a couple of wins.
So we're actually here at the Aria.
You're at the Aria, are you?
I am.
I was waiting to
this
do that.
This is why you need coffee.
I do need coffee, really bad.
So we actually found a little food court.
We did.
Last night. We were kind of like, we got here late. Well, no, we got here yesterday.
Yesterday.
Then we kind of went swimming and chilled a bit.
Yeah.
And then we wandered around and we found this like food court. And we were like, dude, we need to get this for like breakfast.
We do. We had been up there for Salt and Ivy before.
Salt and Ivy.
Is that what they call it?
Yes.
Really great restaurant that we love. We've been there a couple of times. But the food court thing is brand new.
Yeah, so, we haven't seen it.
Yeah, it's really neat. Also, Carbone's up there, by the way.
Oh, Carbone.
We'll just go by and look at it because we have a video on it if you're interested in some of the best Italian food this side of the Mississippi. Anyways, should we get up to the thing?
Let's go.
I'm hungry. All right, headed out. This, by the way, we're in front of Javier's. This place, you guys.
So good.
Unreal. We had the foodie tour there.
Yeah, we did. It was like a lip-smacking foodie tour, which was really good, by the way.
Amazing.
Look it up and do it if you haven't.
We had to stop by the patisserie and see their new display. Look at this.
This is all sugar art.
It's all edible. No one ever gets to eat it, though.
Who do I have to, like, be friends with?
They really should, like, you know, auction off or, like, have a contest for somebody to, like, just have a few bites, like do a little Willy Wonka and go in there.
Yeah, somebody named me. Do you remember when there was a giant edible football?
Yes.
When we were here,
it was like
the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Like I would eat that.
Yeah.
Like no problem.
We
just give me
would.
One of the rocks, because you know those rocks are probably chocolate.
Oh, they probably are.
So let me have a chunk of that. Yeah, I'd also take one of the sugar art leaves right there just to kind of like have that for the day.
Yeah, you know that's candy.
It's making me salivate.
And if you notice the birds, the doves, are... They're kind of like a sour-coated.
You want to say they're sour-coated? I feel like that's just sugar.
I'm sure it is, but it looks like a sour gummy worm-coated type of...
Like that type of coat. Yeah, I understand. Like,
anyways, Katie, there's Buddha.
You gotta rub his belly for good luck.
You can see where it's shiny. Yeah, we should have done that before the
slot machines.
Oh, look. Look, it's the...
There's me.
The lions.
You guys... It's almost Leo season. This is really cool.
Yeah,
I feel like that's you.
I guess I should say thank you. I don't know. All right, this is the appropriate escalator to get upstairs.
Escalate to food. I would honestly eat at that Salt and Ivy place again, too, like easily.
Oh, we get a good view of the store. Look.
Oh, wow. Oh, it says right there, be a lion. Everyone wants to be a lion. I smell food, and it smells real good.
Mr. Unicorn, hello.
Hello.
All right, this is Proper Eats Food Hall. Our first time here. Well, we saw it when it was all closed, but
yeah.
It smells good. I'm kind of dying for an egg sandwich over here. There's a place called Egghead, and they brought one of the sculptures over from like they have in the front. I love these chrome things. And this is Egghead. Look at Mr. Egghead. He's got a nice little haircut going on there. And then Wexler's Deli, very popular. I've heard of that before. They have, you know, some bagels and stuff like that. We want to check out the donut spot as well.
Yeah, it was like now, Easy Donuts or something.
Yeah, this is also the location of the speakeasy in the evening time. We saw it last night. There's a speakeasy right behind this little coffee stand right here. And you can hear music coming out of there at night. Like, it's pretty cool. The Easy Donut speakeasy is right back there. But right now, look at this.
Ooh, reminds me of
Homer Simpson right there. All right, I got what is called a Midtown. It's got egg, bacon, cheese, fried shallots, spicy aioli. Very interesting. It's kind of the one that they are known for, because I was like, oh, I'll get it. It's spicy, yeah, but whatever. And then this is a cheesy hash brown, of which I'm not sure of how much cheese we're talking about, but we will find out. Maybe that's going to be your job to find out what's inside that little hash brown there.
Maybe. I didn't order anything because I'm not like a big egg person at all. Like, I'll eat them, but they're not.
You didn't know. You're kind of in between lunch and
yeah,
you're going to wait.
I don't normally, like in a normal day, I'm not like somebody who's a big breakfast person anyway. So I usually kind of like, I'm a bruncher. I'm an early luncher.
And I need eggs, so I have to have this. But the cool thing is that we're sitting in this like really cool.
It's really nice.
This is a bar that's part of the food hall here, but you can sit anywhere. So look at it. Fancy. Hi.
All right, so Spence is gonna try. I probably would have had a bite of this, but the fact that he got some spicy sauce thing, I'm not gonna even bother. Like, I just know it would hurt me.
I'm guessing that this is kind of modeled after Egg Slut.
Oh yeah, the Egg Slut is over at what, Cosmo?
Yeah, because it, you know, very similar in its presentation and its, you know, kind of gourmet egg sandwich place. The aioli's not, well, I'm not tasting it.
Okay.
I mean, it's just, I'm tasting eggs and cheese, really.
Okay.
And, you know, herbs and things, flavors.
Okay. Do you think I would like it if I was to take a bite of it?
No.
Okay. Maybe I will try a bite. If you're telling me it's
there's
not
tomato,
super spicy,
too.
Okay.
She's going for it.
I am not an eggy person, so this is a little outside of my comfort zone, but here we go.
You were a little eggy this morning. No, I'm just kidding.
I would love this without the egg. Like, I would like just the bacon, the tomato, and you're right, I'm not tasting anything spicy.
Yeah.
That's really weird how that's happening. I'm gonna try one more bite, but I wanna get one on the side here. It's messy.
That's the one thing about this place and Egg Slut, they're messy, but they're cooked really well. They're cooked to order, so you're not getting like a microwave thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's what I like about it. It's not so much a kick as it is a subtle nudge.
And then of course we have this thing. I was looking at it while Spence was eating, and like there's just a gob of cheese. Look at this.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay, the egg sandwich was a smash success. I ended up giving you one half of the bread with the bacon and cheese, and then
yeah.
I took the egg side, and I did detect a little bit more of the spice, but it was so subtle.
Right. I liked it. Like,
yeah.
I'm not starving for like bread. I was hungry, do you know, like where
right.
I could eat right now, but and I want to eat, but I really want like lunchy food.
Yeah.
So, and I thought there'd be lunchy food right now, but we need to try this. What is it called? It's a cheesy hash brown. Okay, I mean, it looks great. Let's kind of break it open and see what is inside, other than potato. Oh, okay. Are we gonna get a cheese pull?
A little bit.
It's got like, ooh, okay, this is what I was curious about. Is it going to have some like oniony, chivey, you know, because that's what you want with like a potato
yeah.
situation.
We are alive with chive. You know what Dylan would do if he were about to eat this? He would chive right in.
Oh boy, he's going to, all right, I'm going to eat this. Mmm, that's excellent. You're going to love that. Delicious. The outside, the inside, I mean, it's got flavor more than just potato and cheese. It's that, like I said, they put some chive or something in there. So it's got a little bit of onion. You can kind of see right there.
Proper Eats Food Hall. That was a success. We will definitely be back.
Yeah, there was a few things I wanted to try.
Behind us, Salt and Ivy, one of our favorite spots.
So good.
The big window, it's just on the pool there.
Yeah, this makes me want to like go to that pool like really bad. We're actually not staying at the Aria. We're staying over at Park MGM again because we
love
it.
Right next door. But for now, we're going to jump in the car. We have somewhere we're going to go. Headed down. It's weird because the pool deck is on this level, but you have to go up to get to the pool.
Yeah, and you got like to get down.
You got to. that's very true. I think it's a little bit raised, but it's out there, you know, kind of facing the freeway. So
I've never seen the pool there before, and now I'm like, oh my gosh! And didn't you look at the map and you said they had like five pools?
I looked
at
the overhead of like, okay, you know, where you're at, and yeah, it looks like there's a bunch of teardrop-shaped pools, but they're rather large.
Comment below if we need to do a night stay here. Comment below and
yeah,
let us know.
If you've stayed here or if you want to see it, because we sure do.
Yeah, I'm
just
interested.
For the pool itself. All right, Aria. That's what I was trying to say. Hey, look who it is.
It's the Din Tai Fung.
It's Din.
It's Din.
It's old Dinny. What's up, Dinny?
Okay, I really like these mugs. Like,
yeah, Din Tai mug.
Those would pressure me into buying those. We were talking about walking back to the car. And going, there's some things we want to check out downtown we haven't done before, so like, why not? No time like the present.
There's the tram.
Oh, I know, it's so tempting to get on the tram.
Well, the escalator's probably broken. No, I shouldn't
say. It's open right now.
It's
I
open.
Saw that. It's okay. Been broken a few times the last time we've been here.
Yeah, that's why I said that. I'm not trying to talk smack, ironically.
No, literally, I'm telling you, it was like at least four different times we've come here, and that escalator going up, and it's not like it's a couple stairs, like it's a hike up those stairs, like you're like like yeah. They almost go straight up, you know.
Oh, yeah.
These ones we've had to walk up too, and this is a pretty good hike up there too.
All right, we're in the East Fremont District. That's Atomic Liquor over there, world famous Atomic Liquor. But right here, it's the Golden Goose, Katie. Look.
I am so excited. I love a Golden Goose. I love a goose in general.
Yes.
Shout out to Pippi and John Wayne at
I
home.
I know. This is, you know.
So you know you made it.
One of their heroes. Look at the golden eggs. This is from an old casino that was on Fremont, kind of where Circa is now. It eventually turned into Glitter Gulch, lasted until even when they put the canopy up for Fremont. Anyways. Old signage, Golden Goose, really rad. Created by Yesco Sign Company, which they created so many of the signs in Vegas, most of them. It's even a cool Fremont mural right here. Kind of reminds me of like a Trav MSK style. He does like really cool kind of signage kind of stuff like this. It's hot, but it's not too bad. I hate to sound cliche, but it's hot, but it is a dry heat. There is something to be said about that.
Honestly, to me, it feels good. Like, I like it a little bit.
Katie is old and cold, so she gets...
That's what's happening.
Yeah. These motels are unbelievable. Like, this era and this style, like the Motor Hotel. Look at this. The Adobe vibes, Route 66 kind of vibes. The signage. Unreal. And it's a whole district of these. That's what the Ferguson Motel was. And they've converted it into this retail space. And some art as well.
I've never been over here.
It's so neat. I'm glad that they're retaining it and leaning into the, you know, what it was. I mean, look at this. You're meant to drive in there.
That's so cool.
And you get your little, it's like in a little apartment, little Adobe apartment.
So cute.
Especially, I guess, if you're from the East Coast and you're coming out here, that what a cool thing that must have been.
Sure, yeah.
Driving Route 66 and ending up here.
Wow.
But yeah, Ferguson's Downtown Motel.
This is awesome.
Sorry, no vacancy, Katie.
Oh, darn it.
Sorry.
So this is literally not a motel at all anymore.
No, and of course, if you've seen any downtown footage of this place, you know this piece. It's from Burning Man, I think.
I've never seen that. I've only seen like a photo here and there.
Yeah, seeing it up close is pretty impressive.
That is so cool.
Big rig jig. It's kind of Banksy-like too, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, the lights are on. Look, that's cool.
That's so awesome.
Reminds me of Steven Spielberg's Duel.
This is awesome. I bet you at night this is like super popular.
Yeah.
Like we're the only crazy people that are out here in the middle of the day when it's 108 degrees.
We came for coffee, to be fair.
We did.
And we thought, what better spot to get a coffee than
yeah
under that piece. Mothership
Coffee. Mothership Coffee Roasters. Yeah. Okay.
kind of dig their logo. It's really nice, especially on a t-shirt with that center placement. The Mothership, love it. Okay, Mothership Coffee Roasters. We got hooked up with some Arnold Palmer's Earl Grey tea with some of their lemonade.
See how it tastes. I'm sure it'll be good because it's so hot out.
The color looks correct. It's like when you see the proper Mai Tai.
You're gonna love this. It's a little sweet, but in a good way.
Okay.
Like the lemonade is definitely like sweet, but it's good. And I love their little cups. I hit the spot, huh?
This is so good because it's got that like fresh, like they used fresh lemons to make this. It's not a powder, whatever the lemonade is.
It's so good. It's so, at first I was thinking maybe it's just so good because it's so hot out, but no, it's good.
I mean, it is. All right, we're cruising around the old motel. We're thinking this used to be the pool down here where it's all dug out, where the coffee place is, because it's kind of got the shape of it anyways, but that's where they naturally were in these places. But look, the on-air.
I want to get one of these. I actually really want one of these, like, see these moons, like the things with the disco light, the disco moon.
It's just amazing that, you know, this is, look at this, this is so cool, man.
Gallery to go.
Oh, is this the art vending machine?
Love those.
These are the best.
Oh, look at those gummy bear earrings. I'm buying those gummy bear earrings. Yay, look at that.
They are pretty cool, though. I do like the blue.
Right?
I think it'll look better on you.
Me too.
Back over by the Traveler's Motel. And look, there's a guy climbing the sign from the E to the T right there.
He's like, water.
Yeah.
I need some water.
Oh, he's climbing down from the sign. Like,
oh,
he's been up there in the heat. He's like,
he's all, forget it. I made a mistake.
There's another classic right there. The Lucky Motel. Ah, oh, 'tis a fine hotel. Love the Las Vegas Motel sign. Like, look at that place. The Fremont Motel, Starview. The Peter Pan, dude. Favorite sign yet, Peter Pan Motel. That is insane. It is clearly gone, not forgotten. So cool, look at the slipper. I think that's Silver Slipper, if I'm not mistaken, even though it's not silver.
There's the Praying Mantis.
Manti and the El Cortez, so rad. Look at this place. You can see all the spray paint sections of the Shepherd Fairey Obey piece over there because they're faded Vegas sun, but you can see they were doing them in like blocks, side to side strokes. Evil Pie, look at the sticker wall there. It's like sticker window that used to be a window. And then Burgers, Beers, Bloody Marys. That's new since we've been here. That wasn't there, I don't think, last time.
I don't think so.
Rolling with my hoagies, Katie. Another famous sign, Vegas sign, repurposed and put down here for display, which is amazing. All right, the top of Binion's up there. We can tell you with certainty at 1:35 in the afternoon in Las Vegas, it is 103 degrees. According to the Binion sign. On our way to the plaza.
Next stop, plaza.
On the next stop, plaza. And then that side of the plaza is an Obey piece. Another Obey piece in Vegas. That one's great. We're going to park at the Garage Mahal, Katie.
That's one of the as good as a...
Parkosaurus Rex.
Or Jurassic Parking.
Jurassic Parking, that's it, yeah.
Things I love.
The same people that named it. Yeah.
Garage Mahal. That is... greatest thing.
Surrounded by kings now, aren't you?
It's the only way to be.
Anyways, we're in front of the Plaza Hotel, the famous, world-famous Plaza Hotel. Look at the bar, the carousel bar right there. We're right across the street from Fremont.
Yeah.
And the Golden Gate, circa. We're looking at a picture. Look, that's how it used to look right there.
So cool.
Anyways, you get the idea. We have never really explored this place. My great-grandma used to come here. One of the many places she came in Las Vegas with a lot of her friends when they were senior citizens. But it was the Union Plaza Hotel when she used to come, which is a reference to the Union Pacific Railroad Station that used to be on this spot, I think turn of the century, probably right around that time, 1908. And Union Pacific Railroad, Union Plaza Hotel. Now it's just the Plaza Hotel. They did some renovations a few years ago. Oscars is right up there, the steakhouse, which is...
We still need to eat there.
Yeah, we got to do an Oscars
session. We need to.
Session, so.
If I can get a reservation, we're going to come and do it.
Yeah. And then also Pink Box Donuts is right here.
I kind of think we need to try one.
Yeah, might as well while we're
Look
here.
Look at the pigeon right here.
There he is.
He just crossed the street. He's coming over.
He's got rhythm.
He's shouting Best Life and Beyond.
He is. Oh.
What's up, guy? See, he just waved to us.
Yeah.
This is so cool. Look at the giant donut.
That's amazing.
Ah, there it is, the plaza and the Golden Gate. The cool thing about Golden Gate is that sign rocks back and forth. I don't know if it's doing it right now, but it does rock back and forth. As if it were in an earthquake. Golden Gate, San Francisco, get it? And here's the entrance.
Look at
to Pink Fox Donuts.
The handles are donuts.
You're gonna need a napkin after you walk
touch
in.
That.
Yeah, it's like a bar.
Dude, that's so cool.
Genius. Okay, this place is really cool. We've got like tags on the wall. The presentation of this place is awesome. Wow.
These are kind of more your standards. This is where it starts to get really cool. These are so cute. Mr. Blueberry.
Ooh.
Look at the bedtime bear.
Wow.
Oh, dude, here's my favorite, the peace sign.
Are you going to get that?
That's the best donut ever.
I think biting into it would be the coolest thing.
You just hold it up. Is that what you're going to hold up like you always do for your photos?
I normally do.
Look at all the donuts back there. They're ready for business. And they have coffee. Who doesn't want coffee from that awesome display right there?
Oh, that's awesome. I like the merchandise over there.
The fact that the sprinkles on the wall are glowing is so Vegas and so perfect. This whole place, whoever did the art direction in here, genius. Snap it, tag it, share it. Pink Box Donuts, Plaza Las Vegas. There he is, Pinky. I think that's his name. Friends with Pinky. Hey, look, they are actually showing the Shepherd Fairey piece and telling you who did it, and then Fail, also an artist who's featured here. Oh, that's cool. I'm glad they do that. There's Fail's piece on the other side. Hey, there's Hash House of Go-Go. Okay, this is really fun because we never come over here, so we're like, oh, wow, look at this. Oh.
All right, here is our donut selections. Spencer went with the peace sign in honor of dating a millennial, because if you're a millennial, you know this is kind of our go-to. This and duck lips, it's what we do.
Right. And also, you guys are into emojis because you're internet kids.
So, we got the poop.
I mean,
this is good for people who like chocolate, aka me. It's a heavy dookie. Now, the thing is it is a cake donut, which is not my favorite.
Yeah.
But hopefully the fact that it's chocolate and it's very dense, I feel like that'll make up for it. I don't even know how you eat it. You just like, or do you, we're just going to bite it, see what happens.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah.
So
honestly,
what's on top? More cake?
We're going to find out. Oh.
Oh, like a mousse almost?
Like a frosting? I'm going to dip some of this cake in there and let's see what happens. Sometimes places like this, it's kind of all hype and it's not really a good tasting thing. It's so sweet. All right, you got your peace sign. Better take a bite of it now.
This is my peace pose.
Peace pose. It's me. Now you need duck lips. Do me. That's Katie. Oh my gosh. Yeah, go for it.
Oh, you know what? You got to be careful which finger you take.
Oh, you're right.
I'd rather leave it to be a number one than something else. But
I think so.
You get the idea.
Wow.
Now something that we all know, and we've all known for a long time, that I am number one. And Katie, sorry.
No.
But yeah, that's the reality here. Numero uno.
You're not number one during Leo season, which is coming very soon.
We don't talk about that until it's here.
Oh, okay. Just can't figure out what we're gonna have for dinner tonight.
Elliot. All right, we're at Derby Deluxe, Katie's favorite game, probably, I would say, of all. And they're off.
We really want six to win.
Is this what you got?
Because I did a lot of sixes, and then I did two and four.
Oh, okay. There they go.
Six. Oh, no, he's in the back. Come on, six. Oh, he's coming up. He's coming up. He's coming up. Come on, six. We need you to steady, steady. Get it, get it. Oh.
Did we even place?
No.
Wait, six. Yeah, third. We placed.
Yeah,
or show. Win, place, or show. That's a show.
I know. I didn't win, though.
All right. What do we got this time?
I got a few of them. Oh, number five. Are you serious? Out of nowhere. No, I was close. This is my last one. I'm betting $1 on number six, and that's it.
To win?
Yep. Number six is
going to win. Did you hear
that? I heard the whinny.
Is that a whinny for the win?
For the whinny.
No more
for the whinny.
I've got bad luck today. I'm not doing very good.
Wait, he won!
Did you win?
Yes!
I won $9. I got back. I should have bet more. That's fine, though. I'll take it. I'm back up to 94. Woo! As literally the most, not great, whatever, it doesn't matter.
What was the horse's name? Prickly Vinny. Pete?
Vinny. Feels like a Vinny, didn't he? He gives you that, vibe. Thank goodness.
All right, you guys, we're back at the Go-Go Claw, one of Katie's favorite games. This one's a little different. We've never seen this. This is Go-Go Claw gold bars. Look. I mean, they're not real, but
yeah. They're
I guarantee they're foam or something, but...
It just looks cool.
Yeah, it's the money in the other machine is just fake money anyway, so...
And this is fun because it's near impossible to win.
Yeah.
I'm just going to put two $5 bills in and just try it.
You're gonna, that's a go-go, a 5-5 go-go claw.
I know that these will be lost, but it's okay.
Yeah, you're just doing a go-go.
That's it.
Quick go-go. No, I mean, it takes a little bit of skill to try to at least get something that's...
I don't think it even grabs on, though. That's what my thing is.
Welcome to Go-Go Claw!
She's so optimistic. That scares me. It looks like the Price is
Starting
Right wheel.
Selection!
Oh my gosh.
This is the ball prize value. Grab a prize ball.
A lot going on. You got 25 seconds.
Here.
Where's Katie gonna go with the go-go claw? There she goes. Oh no. Oh, Katie.
I got one more try. Don't worry. It said exactly what you said. Oh no. Should I try the other one?
Come to the side and look.
Okay.
I would go for like...
Welcome, starting selection.
All right, she's
this
going again.
This is the ball prize value.
Hey, there's the claw. Your way. More. Keep going. A little hair more. Right there.
Okay.
There we go. That was the one we were going for.
Oh, no, that was so close.
That's no-no claw for us.
That's the fail claw.
Go claw.
Papa Pizza. That's cool. Right next to Colossal Stars.
$5.
Look how big it is. That is so cool. It doesn't have an arm. It's just a button style. But I remember they had these in downtown on the street, they were still in the casino, but you could almost like Vegas Vacation, you could do it on the street, you know?
I love the
chandeliers in here. This old school vibe is so cool. Hey, look, we found the PSA vending machine. It's the Pokemon graded card vending machine. I think they have sports cards too.
Yeah
they do. That shows it right there. One graded card in every box, but the machine is down. We saw this online, so I figure a lot of people have come by. Out of stock. Everything's out.
Yeah.
So they're anywhere from looks like 50 to 75 bucks.
Refill requested. Look at the Charizard. I actually have that card.
Oh, look at that.
I don't know what edition
this is. This is what they make you think you're going to get, a hologram Charizard, which is...
I literally have one, but again, I don't know what edition it is. I just know we got it a long time ago, my sister and I. Dang.
Too bad. We'll have to maybe check back tomorrow.
Maybe instead we have to do the giant spinneroo.
Yeah. I mean,
I feel good about it.
The thing with this is, part of me is glad that it's... I wanted to see it,
at least
but
see it.
My thing is that I'm not really a card collector anymore. I have some from the old days, but it would be... I would do it just for maybe the video, just to see if we got something.
What do you call it?
For posterity, for...
Word novelty
and science.
Novelty, science,
yeah,
fun.
Now this is something that's really cool that they have here: the fireworks viewing party Fridays,
up on their pool deck.
Dude.
And I believe that's the fireworks that are inspired by Disney.
Yeah, and you don't even have to be up on the pool deck. But, no. You know, that, like,
but look,
it's
there's,
funny.
There's Katie with her alligator float. Yeah. Whoa, another big one. Look, this one's Oscar's for the steakhouse. And then, look at
now
this.
Now I'm hungry for steak.
We're headed upstairs because we heard there's a bingo room up here.
Craving big, steak now.
And I want to see the bingo hall. Katie wants steak.
Yeah, ooh,
look at
I
that.
Want both.
That's cool.
Wow. Hey.
There we
subscribe.
Are.
Subscribe. Best Life and Beyond. Ooh. Woo. Oh.
Don't trip and fall. All right. So.
Whoa. Union Plaza. Then and
oh,
now.
This is some little history cabinets here.
How cool.
There's the old Union Plaza sign, like I was saying, that it used to be called that. And this is the stuff that I remember from my great grandma was like cups like this. These types of things. She always had these neon things, the matchbooks. Are there any matchbooks in here? Oh yeah, there's one. Yeah, my grandma collected matchbooks, and so there's, she probably had that one. Look at, that's an original jacket. Wow. There's some matchbooks there. Now, I recall seeing the gold one. Look at this foam trucker hat, dude. Oh my God, that's amazing.
What? That's literally today.
July 1st is when this place opened?
I don't know, but I just know that that literally is
that
today.
That photo is today. I just got chills.
That's weird.
Okay, this is really bizarre.
Literally.
That we came here. I have chills.
I know, I do too. Them. It's freaking me out.
And it's not cold. It's like 105. As we sit here in front of the memorabilia, we wouldn't have known had we not looked in these cases, which I always love doing. Dude.
It's July 1st right now. Like, look at the... You can see it right there. Hold on, let me unlock. July 1st.
July 1st. And so, it's a year younger than me.
Wow.
Are they celebrating? What's up? Is there a pin?
We
what's going
go
on?
We need to go eat at Oscars.
I know, look at...
Can we get a resi?
What I love about Oscars is that it looks like the Alfred Hitchcock logo. Look at, there's Katie on the left. All right, we're headed up further. There's the bingo parlor, Katie. Look, there it is. Las Vegas Jerkies. What's that? I think it's a store. Okay, so there's...
Is that real?
That's what it looked
that's
like.
That's on top of Oscars?
No, that's where Oscars is now.
Oh.
It used to be a pool, though.
What?
Isn't that insane? Overlooking...
This was August 29th, 1972.
Wow.
I love the history.
Okay, here's the bingo hall, and it says, play daily, 11-1-3-5-7-9, located... on the third floor, home of the $160,000 Super Bingo. They have a vending machine for the dabbers, or the daubers, or whatever they called it, for your how you mark
I
your cards,
one.
Dude. I wish we had time to do that, but that is
me
really
too.
Neat.
That's awesome.
Checking out the view of Oscars right here, which used to be the pool deck that you saw in that photo, which is amazing. And then look at the bar down here. It's a great bar, the carousel, and then...
Look at Circa, and then that's their pool. They kind of have the vibes.
Oh, this, the stadium.
Their pool technically is like right
it's up there,
there right?
Yeah, stadium swim. They all the screens are where that wall is, so it all faces that
so
way.
In a way, it's kind of got the vibe.
It really does.
Circa actually has a really good view if you look at it.
All right, so we booked dinner here tonight, so you're going to have to subscribe. Hit the notification bell if you want to see that meal and the night that occurs within that. We're going to make a whole video of Oscars and some other fun things.
Yeah,
so.
Maybe Oscars might be a separate video. We're yeah. not sure, but either way, we got videos coming.
We got a res, so look forward to that. Pigeon Plaza.
Every Friday. Okay, so it is every Friday.
I think the coolest thing about downtown is that they've retained the light bulb vibe everywhere. If you look around, even Circa, which is brand new, has retained the popcorn bulbs. And, you know, much like the plaza here and all that, it's like so important, honestly, it really is. Because the Strip doesn't really have any of that anymore. All right, we're down at Fremont. Zipliners are getting back from their journey. We passed the Golden Gate and its bar. Look at that. They got all the frozen drinks back there. You could be like Cousin Eddie and get one of these.
Oh my God.
I do like the front of Circa. And they kind of vet their customers, and which is smart. Little metal detector action, you know.
Oh, that's smart. Yeah, I like that.
Golden Nugget. As we make our way through. It's so cool how they have all these big stages, you know? And a close second place, the El Portal sign is my other favorite, because look at that building. Ancient. Katie, we're gonna run into Binion's to check out the $1 million. All right, Katie. Can you smell it?
No.
Just behind this sign. You gotta be 21. Check your ID, please.
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, the $1 million. There it is. Look at this. Look at it. On the good whiskey, too. Oh, look at this. You can take your own photo back here. All right, let's do it.
Let's look there. Ready?
Okay, ready?
1, 2, 3. Okay, let's go take.
All right, there we were. Pretty cool. All right, thanks, Binions. We're going back outside. We love cool, free stuff like that, you know?
It's fun.
Yeah, that's what Vegas is about for us anyways. Oh, there he is, Vegas Vic. He says, howdy, Katie.
Howdy.
I love the carousel bar signage right here. Look at this. Amazing. Truly a work of art. The symmetry pleases me. Katie noticed that these horses are actually going up and down. Gotta watch closely, but they're moving. We're back to the Garage Mahal.
Yeah, we're gonna have to go back to our hotel, get dressed, come back.
So, Garage Mahal or Jurassic Parking?
I mean, Garage Mahal.
Wow.
Yeah.
Big claims.
Sorry, Universal.
Wow. Well, the gauntlet has been thrown down because Kitty's having the time of her life here at Circa. Yeah, this parking structure serves both Circa and the plaza, as you can see, so it's nice. Here's what you pay for parking over here at the old Garage Mahal. I'm gonna say that more times, so if you guys are playing a drinking game, I'm gonna keep saying it. I'm gonna spreckle it through the video.
Spreckle.
Yeah. All right, we're out of here. Happy birthday, plaza. Ironic that we're here on your birthday. We'll be back later. Well, you're looking at New York, New York. That means we're back on the south side of the Strip, Park MGM. We're about to make our way over to New York, New York, but we're gonna go through this casino and then we'll cross the street over there and go have some pizza, I think. Katie's wanting pizza. She's gonna nod yes. She doesn't have a mic on. It's kind of good. I can just speak. You're not allowed to speak. No one can hear you. Even if you try to speak, no one can hear you. Yeah, see? It's amazing. I love this power. Let's just do this all the time. No, just kidding. But anyways, yeah, we're going to go do that. The beat goes on. Just, you know, bouncing around today. All right, we made it over from Park MGM. We're going to head in to New York, New York, going in.
All I've had today is half of that yogurt. And I realized we really didn't eat that much. Like, I had a little bit of your egg sandwich, though. So
yeah.
And it's now, what time is it? 5:20. I'm hungry.
You're hangry.
I'm hangry. Ooh, look at that. That's so good. We couldn't even pizza cheers because I'm already so far in.
Couldn't wait, but
I'm too hungry.
I'm not holding it against you, trust me.
I'm way too hungry right now.
All right, we're back outside in the park. I think they call this the park. Got some Vegas Knights gear. Some nice stuff, actually. Katie and I wanted to adopt the Vegas Knights as our hockey team.
I know. I don't have one.
We don't really like...
We aren't fans of any professional sport teams.
No.
Like, I like them all. I think they're all great.
Yeah, but we might adopt the Vegas
Knights. Let's be a Vegas Knights people.
Because we would, you know, go to the games here and stuff.
I would, yeah.
Anyways. Anyways, it was a great first day here in Vegas. We're having a blast. More vlogs to come. We have an amazing night planned
for
tonight, which includes Oscars as well as some other things that, yeah, that'll be a surprise. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching. Thank you, Patreons. More Vegas content coming to you. All right, that's it, I promise. That's all.
Okay.
Bye-bye, everybody.